بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه ما بعد. We are continuing in our discussion of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And today we have now moved on to the name of Allah. We're going to move on to the name of Allah, Al-Latif. Al-Latif. And the name of Allah, Al-Latif, comes from the verb latafa. And the verb latafa, actually it's a very profound and a deep verb. And it has multiple connotations, but the primary meaning of this verb is the lightness of being and presence. To not make your presence even known. To be very discreet and not show. It's a very hidden type of presence. And we see this verb manifested in Surah Al-Kahf in the story of the sleepers of the cave. Remember, they went to sleep for 300 plus years. And they woke up and they didn't realize how long they had slept. And Allah says that their leader said to them, here, take this money, take this waraqa, take this money, and go to the city, وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ, and be latif. So from this, everybody can understand what is the meaning of be latif. وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ, be very careful, nobody recognizes you, be discreet. Go and make sure nobody, you're not the center of attention. Do what you need to do without making your presence felt. This is the actual meaning of latafa, the primary meaning of latafa. And there's also a connotation of being aware. So when he is being sent to the city, he's being told, see what's happening, get the pulse of the community, and bring back that information without your presence being known to the people. Okay, so we see the verb وَلْيَتَلَطَّفْ being used in its actual meaning here. So when it comes to Allah Azza wa Jal being Al-Latif, there are two meanings, both of which complement one another. The first meaning, Al-Latif, is the one who is aware of the hidden affairs. Al-Latif, the one who knows the hidden. And this has the connotation, as we said, of the person going and seeing what's going on in the community without them being aware. So Allah is aware of our secrets, even though we might not be aware, we told anybody. We're hiding what we want to hide. But Al-Latif is aware of those hidden secrets. This is the first meaning of Al-Latif. And the second meaning of Al-Latif goes back to being discreet as you go about doing what you need to be done. And when it comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has a very beautiful meaning. Al-Latif is the one whose mercy reaches you in manners you don't even understand. Al-Latif is the one who shall bless you and you don't even know you were blessed. Al-Latif is the one who shall take care of your affairs without even you understanding that your affairs have been taken care of. Because that's what Al-Latif implies. That the Rahmah will come and you don't understand where or how, and you might not even recognize the Rahmah until afterwards you look back and you realize, oh, that was such a blessing that occurred to me. So this is the meaning of Al-Latif. And in the Quran, Allah is described as the proper noun Al-Latif five times. Five times. The proper noun Al-Latif. And by the way, take this as a rule of thumb. Anytime the proper noun occurs in the Quran, it is one of the 99 names of Allah. Okay, remember there's a bit of a confusion going on, and inshallah towards the end I'll clarify again so that everybody understands. Allah's names are how many? Who can remind me?
Infinity.
Unlimited. Allah's names are infinity. We don't even know. Of those infinite names, the Quran and Sunnah comes with hundreds. Hundreds. If you were to sit down and compile a list in the Quran and Sunnah, from the verbs, from the adjectives, from the descriptions, and from the proper nouns, you get hundreds. From those hundreds, scholars have to extract the prime 99. Is that clear? Right? So, anytime a proper noun, As-Sami', Al-Basir, Al-Ghafur, Ar-Rahman, occurs in the Quran, clearly not only is it a name, it is one of the 99 names. The proper noun. The problem comes to extract, like we said, Al-Jameel and whatnot, the hadith finds it and whatnot. This is where the controversy comes. Al-Latif is a proper noun in the Quran. So there's no question. Al-Latif is one of the names of Allah. And it occurs in the proper noun form 5 times. Every one of those 5 times, it is always linked with the same name. Every time the proper noun occurs, it's always linked with the same name. And that is, who can tell me? Oh, Hafidh of the Quran, Hafidh of the Quran. Al-Latif al-Khabir. Al-Latif al-Khabir. All 5 times, every time the word Latif occurs, it is Al-Latif al-Khabir. Why? Khabir is the one who is aware of the open. Latif is the one who is aware of the hidden. Latif, the one who is aware of secrets. Khabir, the one who is aware of that which is open. So Allah is Al-Latif and Al-Khabir. He knows what you're hiding. He knows what's in my heart. He knows what's in our minds. He knows that secret that nobody knows. That is Al-Latif. And He is Al-Khabir, the one who is aware of everything. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentions this name, as I said, 5 times. And of those times, for example, in Surah Tabarak, أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Doesn't it make sense that the one who created everything should know everything? أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقَ. How can Allah not know? أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ. When He created you, and He created your heart and my mind and your soul and my body, surely He knows what's in your soul and my mind. Surely He knows what we're hiding. أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ. It's a rhetorical question. How can anybody deny Allah's knowledge? أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ. Indeed, Allah is اللطيف and الخبير. Also in the Quran, Surah Luqman, when Luqman is giving advice to his son, Luqman's famous advice to his son, يَا بُنَيْ إِنَّهَا أَن تَكُ مِثْقَالَ حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ فَتَكُنْ فِي صَخْرَةٍ أَوْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ أَوْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يَأْتِ بِهَا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَطِيفٌ خَبِيرٌ. Oh my son, even if it is a حَبَّةٍ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ, they translate as a mustard seed. In fact, the meaning here is an atoms, or the smallest. The Arabs have an expression, حَبَّ مِّنْ خَرْدَلٍ. It means the smallest of the small. Even if it is an atom, even if it is the smallest thing, and you hid it under a rock or a stone, or you hid it somewhere in the heavens or earth, Allah will bring it back. Allah knows it. Allah is what? Al-Latif and Al-Khabir. So, Al-Latif and Al-Khabir, they always occur together in the Quran 5 times. 2 times in the Quran, and this is rare for a name, but if for Latif it occurs, Allah uses it as a direct description of Himself. That Allahu latifum bi'ibadi. Allahu latifum bi'ibadi. This is in the Quran. This is very rare that Allah takes a proper noun, uses it as a description of Himself. Allah is latif with His servants. And this shows us the importance of the name of Allah al-Latif. Allahu latifum bi'ibadi. How? What does He do? Yarzuqu man yasha. This is what the verse is saying. He gives His rizq to whomever He pleases, however He pleases. And therefore, what this ayah means here is that Allah's rizq, look at how Allah links al-latif with rizq. Allahu latifun bi'ibadi yarzuqu man yasha. How so? Allah is saying, oh, you who are worried about your sustenance, your money, your paycheck, don't worry, you will get it. I have methods to give it to you. You won't even know how it's going to come. It's going to come. I am the Latif and I will give you the rizq. Because I am the one who provides. And I am the one who provides in manners you don't even recognize. So the name of Allah, Al-Latif, is Allah is reminding His servants that haven't I taken care of you so far? Didn't you get to where you are now? And you were stuck so many times, but you got out of that. Because my lutf, managed to reach you from ways you never expected. وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. Allah's rizq will come from sources you never expected, because Allah is Al-Latif. And one of the great scholars of the past, the linguist by the name of Az-Zajjaj, he said that Al-Latif is the one who is generous to his servants in secret, so that even the servants do not understand that the generosity, where is it coming from? Even the servant does not understand how their affairs are being taken care of. And so Allah is Latif, and Rizq is one of the main manifestations of that. And we said there are 2 times it occurs in the Quran as a proper description. Number one, Allahu Latifun bi'ibadi. Number 2 is in the story of Yusuf alayhi salam. And it's very appropriate in the story of Yusuf that right at the end of the story, after Yusuf has gone through the bottom of the well and the dungeons of the prison and being seduced and being thrown here and taken to the ministry and then becoming the minister of finance, this whole journey, what does Yusuf say? What name of Allah does he mention? Right at the very end, he makes that beautiful dua. And then he says, Inna Rabbi Latifun Lima Yasha. This is what lutf is. You want to understand lutf? The story of Yusuf makes us understand what is lutf. And at the end, Yusuf mentions this name of Allah. Inna Rabbi Latifun Lima Yasha. How did I end up at the bottom of a well, and then inside of a dungeon, and then in the palaces of Aziz and being seduced, and then throughout all of this, Allah Azza wa Jal is taking care of me. And had I not been in the previous situation, I wouldn't have gone to the next one until finally I am the minister of finance of the greatest civilization known to man at that time, and that is ancient Egypt. Were I not in dungeon, were I not in the well, were I not being seduced, I would not have ended up here. And Allah was taking care of me, and I did not recognize it, but now I see, إِنَّ رَبِّي لَطِيفٌ لِمَا يَشَاءُ. My Rabb is Latif to whomever He wants to be. إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْعَلِيمُ الْحَكِيمُ. So Yusuf's story is the perfect manifestation of Allah Azza wa Jalla's lutf that you do not understand. But Allah is Latif. And Allah will use every opportunity not only to protect you, but to provide in a way and from a means and from a source you will never understand. And if you put your trust in Al-Latif, then all of your affairs will be taken care of. So the name of Allah, Al-Latif, is used for many purposes and reasons. Primarily, the name of Allah, Al-Latif, it should bring about both a fear and a hope. It's one of those names, has two meanings, they're both complementary. As for the meaning of fear, we should be fearful of Al-Latif who is aware of our secrets. Al-Latif is aware of our hidden. And the hope, Al-Latif is the one who shall gently protect. Because we said one of the meanings of lutf is to be not visible, not harsh, to be very gentle. Allah will gently protect, discreetly protect. Protect without even us realizing He's protecting. Provide without even us seeing where the provision is coming from. This is Al-Latif. And so we use the name of Allah, Al-Latif, especially in distressing circumstances. Ya Latif, you see my situation. Ya Latif, you see where I am. I need your lutf. Your lutf will protect me, even if I don't understand how. So the name of Allah, Al-Latif, is a powerful name to use, and especially when we're invoking Allah Azza wa Jal in a difficult situation, we want His hidden protection, His hidden rizq, His hidden provision. We want every affair of ours to be directed and managed by the one who's directing and managing. We don't even know, we can't even see, we can't even feel, but we trust. Like Yusuf trusted that in the end we shall end up in the best position because Allah is Latif with His servants. May Allah Azza wa Jal shower us with His lutf and envelop us in His mercy. And inshallah we will continue tomorrow. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.